രാജശ്രീ വെങ്കിട്ടരമണൻ. 15-ാമത്തെ 130 വാക്ക് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഷോർട്ട് ആൻഡ് ഡിക്റ്റേഷനാണ് വായിക്കാൻ പോകുന്നത്. നിങ്ങൾ 14 നല്ലവണ്ണം പ്രാക്ടീസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും എന്ന് വിചാരിക്കുന്നു. സബ്സ്ക്രൈബ് ചെയ്യാത്തവരുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ചെയ്യണം. നമുക്ക് വായിക്കാൻ ഇപ്പോൾ തുടങ്ങാം. മിസ്റ്റർ സ്പീക്കർ, ഐ മസ്റ്റ് അറ്റ് ദ ഔട്ട്സെറ്റ് താങ്ക് യു ഫോർ ഗിവിംഗ് മീ ദിസ് ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി ടു ടേക്ക് പാർട്ട് ഇൻ ദ ജനറൽ ഡിസ്കഷൻ ഓൺ ദ ബഡ്ജറ്റ് ഫോർ ദി ഇയർ. I wish to congratulate the Honorable Finance Minister on his presenting such a good budget which aims at improving the conditions of the weaker sections of the society. He has done well to represent such a balanced budget in the present circumstances. Let me first refer to the functioning of the Education Department. On the whole, I should say that the offices of the department have done a good job. There might be a few minor lapses here and there. For instance, there has been some delay in the publication of the results, the higher secondary examinations. Of course, there might be valid and justifiable causes for such a delay. But considering the difficulty that such delay causes to the students, parents and also the educational institutions, the department could have avoided the delay in this regard. I am happy to note that the department has taken note of the criticisms made in the past years with regard to the delay in the sanction of grants and scholarships and had taken effective steps to ensure that the schools received the grants and the students received the scholarships in time. I thank the departmental officers for being responsive to the suggestions and remarks made on the floor of the house. As regards sales tax, I think there is much room for toning up the administration of this department. A number of members who spoke before we have referred to many complaints made by the merchants, traders and businessmen about the harassment to which they were being subjected by the department. The government should realize that they are getting a huge sum of by way of sales tax, which helps them to undertake many welfare schemes. The government should issue suitable instructions to the executive staff to be kind and considerable to the assessees. Whenever the assessees committed some errors out of ignorance of law, the officers should politely point out those errors to them and educate them as to how they should help the government by paying the taxes due by them. There should be perfect understanding and cordiality between the assessees and the department. Once these are established, I'm sure there would be no room for many of the complaints that are now being made against the officials. The task of collection of tax is a difficult and delicate one, and it should be dealt with carefully. As far as the Forest Department is concerned, I would like to congratulate the Honorable Minister in charge on the keen personal interest taken by him to prevent the indiscriminate cutting of trees in the forest. We know very well how forests are essential for the prosperity of any country. We notice a tendency on the part of some people to destroy forests for various personal uses without realizing the great harm they are doing. Of course, there are laws to prevent such indiscriminate cutting of trees, but as in many other fields, mere laws would not be adequate to tackle this problem. The cooperation of the people is also essential. The people should voluntarily come forward to cooperate with the officials and stop cutting of trees. The officials on their part should always be very strict in dealing with the offenders in this respect. As regards the cooperation department, the fine objective of the cooperative movement is not being achieved in many cases. Rules and regulations are violated very often. Also, we see misuse of funds. Letter dated 15th May 1983 from the Star Electronics Limited, Bombay to Messrs. Balaji and Sons, Madras. Dear Sirs, kindly refer to your letter in which you have complained about the delay in our sending the various articles ordered by you. We regret very much the inconvenience caused to you in this connection. However, we request you to consider the circumstances under which we could not fulfill our commitment to you as promised. A section of the labor staged a stay in strike about 2 weeks ago, though the other sections were willing to work, it was not possible to keep the factory open for security reasons. Hence, we have declared a lockout. The demands of the workers are not reasonable and are against the terms of the agreement entered into between their representatives and the management.